Became an MSP myself in 2016. I was, as well as being a local councillor for a couple of years before that. I was sort of my intro into politics. I was also a social worker. Worked in child protection for 8 years as well. So I feel as if I've got a fairly good grounding in that area. One of the first things that I wanted to do when I got involved in politics was start a campaign around paternity leave. So I'd done that maybe about a year or so in. So it was about 2017, so it was quite a modest campaign actually when I look back on it, because a lot's kind of developed since, especially when you hear about what Aviva are doing. But really what I was looking at was increasing the entitlement from 2 weeks, which is currently a week paid and a week unpaid, to 4 weeks fully paid. So quite a modest campaign when I look back on it, but I don't want people to get too hung up on that, on the 4 weeks issue, because it's actually grown quite a lot since then. And the principles of paternity leave and how it can tackle gender inequality is actually what's really come out. So to let you know what I've done with that, as well as visiting Aviva and hearing about their good stuff, I took a motion to my own party conference. This is not, I'm not here in any political capacity, I have to say that, but just so that you know, I'm an SNP member, so I took it to the SNP party conference. And that is now part of policy for at least 4 weeks, 4 weeks paternity leave. So that's actually part of policy has been changed as a result of this. And also to get into the members debate in the Scottish Parliament, where we got full cross-party support. Every single party in the Parliament supported the notion of at least 4 weeks. And actually the vast majority of us in every party who spoke in that debate felt there was a lot of evidence that we should be going a lot further. My actual biggest worry when I first started off the campaign, I go back and say, I can't really believe when I look back on it how an unjustified worry it was that when I first done it, I was quite cautious with it. I didn't want a lot of media attention around it at first. I thought, you know, people are just going to say, here's a quite middle-aged man, you know, fighting for dads, there's much bigger issues around gender inequality. I know, you know, what I think about it and how it can tackle gender inequality, and I was really worried about that. But it was a worry I didn't need to have, because I have had nothing, not any negative criticism to this campaign whatsoever. In fact, if anything, lots of people, like Sam, for example, through Fathers Network Scotland, have really, really helped me to kind of develop it. And I think that that worry's not been there, and that's allowed me to be more confident talking about it and taking it forward. And I think it is important that on International Women's Day that, you know, we've got an event like this, for talking about how paternity leave can impact on gender inequality. I think it's really important, that we have this, and it is obviously a real honour to speak about it on this day as well. And, I did get jokes. I think I was laughing there when you said I did get jokes, because when my partner, when I told her about the campaign and was speaking to her about it, she did say stuff like, oh, that's a great campaign, but I wouldn't want you around any more meetings, but sounds good for everybody else type of thing. But obviously, I think she was all joking, I'm not sure, but I definitely think she was. But I think that the main thing is that we can use paternity leave to really break down some of the gender stereotypes that existed. The man's a breadwinner and the woman's job's care. And I think that we're really shifting away from that. It allows us, as well as having the conversation, it allows men, I think, to challenge ourselves. And I think we still do need to be honest. I mean, I always say, like, you know, let's just be honest about it. The research suggests that men are doing now about 50% of what a woman does, so about a quarter of the overall childcare responsibilities. We all know in this room that that's not enough. But let's be honest about it. I think that roughly fits in to where I am with my partner. Probably. Maybe a wee bit more, but probably. But am I doing more than my dad did? Hope he doesn't watch this video, by the way. But am I doing more than my dad did? Yeah, definitely. Did my dad do more than my granddad did? definitely. So we're moving, generationally we're moving, and I think that campaigns like this, the work of the various organisations that are here, you know, organisations like Aviva, that can help lead the way. And I think, you know, in a matter of 10, 20 years' time, there'll be a lot more organisations following that lead, and you'll have been the market leader that you want to be. We know as well that from the countries where there's 10, 12 weeks in place, that there's real benefits for that in breaking down gender inequalities. So I think that's really where we need to get to. I do have to say that I'm not a fan. I don't know what other people's views are around the table, but I'm not a fan of the shared paternity scheme from the UK government. I think the intention is right. I don't think there's any ill-conceived intention with it. I think it was the right thing. I think it was generally received, it was generally well supported when it was first brought out, but I think there's a lot of difficulties with it. I think it actually reinforces the gender stereotypes. I think it reinforces, if a woman then, chooses to not have the full maternity leave, then she's having to make that choice. I think that there's a real, real strong, campaign around a separate scheme for dads or the other carer. And I think that's where we need to go. I'm going to be having further discussions with Sam and Alison over the next kind of few weeks and months, and we are actually looking at, starting a proper campaign about getting this particular power devolved. Can't make any promises on that just now because there's various difficulties in that because it's tied in other reserved issues which it wouldn't be suitable to be devolved, or they would have already been through the Smith Commission. But there's a possibility there we can start drilling into how, if we can't get it devolved, what we can do to kind of make it work. So all I would do is ask you to watch your space for that campaign. And I suppose I'll just leave it at that, but I would just obviously want to say a big thanks to everybody for having me here and allowing me to close your event. But a big thanks to Aviva for all that they do, for Sam, for all our organisation, and Fathers Network in Scotland. And I hope everybody's a great day.
Thanks for watching. Thank you.